What's up? Well, I've covered this topic before, but I've had a few people ask me to do it again, and it's been coming up recently in a lot of conversations, and it's about bullying. I know both sides of that coin. I got bullied some when I was a kid, young. I was a bully for a while. And even though I know why I was a bully, the whole psychological part of it, doesn't make it right. And I've apologized to some of the people that I bullied. I'm friends with them. Still doesn't make it all right. And there's a few others. I mean, I didn't bully a whole bunch of people that, well, I don't think I bullied a whole bunch of people. But I haven't ever came in contact with any of the other ones that I bullied. It's a short list. I mean, I can count them. I remember the people that I bullied and shit. The difference with bullying, and again, this doesn't make it okay or better or anything like that. I'm just saying the difference between bullying when I was growing up in the 70s and 80s is way different than the bullying they're doing now. I mean, kids are committing suicide. They're being killed. I mean, they're physically fucked up. Now, as an adult, when I see what's happening now, it fucking breaks my heart, man. I know I'm all that hardcore and all that shit, but I cannot fucking stand to see someone bullying somebody. Part of the problem, and I'm, again, please, I am not excusing bullying or justifying it or anything like that, but part of what's making bullying so bad now, fuck, that will sound like I'm putting it off on the victims, and I'm not. Let me try to go from this angle, because I don't want anybody misinterpreting this, going, do you hear what that fucker's saying? That's not. I don't want you to miss what I'm actually saying. When I was growing up, we got called some bad fucking shit. Everybody did. I mean, I cannot count how many times I was called faggot because I had long hair. And most of it was just because that. I don't act gay. I got called faggot a lot. You can't be much farther from being gay than I am. And that was just based on how I looked. But it didn't bother me. I mean, what the fuck ever. And I guess that may have something to do with me and my self-worth and my own thoughts and about myself and all this stuff. Because I was raised different. The early part of my life, I was abused, not sexually. That's a whole different story. I wasn't sexually abused, but my biological father beat the fucking dog shit out of us, which is why I know now I spent a short time as a bully because I couldn't control what was happening at home, but I could control everything else outside of that. Again, doesn't make it right. I am not justifying it. What I'm trying to do is show you that I've put a lot of thought into why I was the way I was and how I helped evolve into it. A better person. But people today are taking shit to extremes. Like I keep bringing up because I'm stunned about Tom Segura getting death threats over jokes about Cajuns. Fucking crazy. Retarded. As I said the other day, the word is not bad. It's developed. It's been blown out into something that it's not. And most of us didn't call people that were mentally challenged retarded. We called each other retarded for doing stupid shit. That was the next level stupid. But now all of a sudden, oh, you can't say that. You see those floaters that keep flying by? Maybe it's just me. Weird. But now you're being told what you can't say. we went through this. I mean, we were called horrible names. There are a lot of horrible names, and it's just the way it was. But we all developed thick skin, and we drove on. Again, not saying it's okay, but stop giving these people power, or these words power that they don't deserve. You need to believe in you. And if it's your children, you need to teach your children to believe in themselves, to know that whatever the fuck somebody else is saying about them doesn't matter. That's just the verbal bullying. Physical bullying is a whole different fucking level. What's going on these days is these kids are seeing just how much farther they can push it. They're fucking hurting kids. Hurting them. I mean, knocking them the fuck out. Shit like that. And they're picking kids who are going through some fucked up shit as it is. It's not like they're picking on other bullies. That's way better for me. I beat up my fair share of bullies once I got out of my bullying stage and realized, oh, this is fucked up. So it was way better for me to beat up a bully, especially in front of the person they were bullying. The level of violence is what we've got to get a hold of. But it also starts at home. I mean, there are fucking kids in junior high committing suicide. They don't even know what life is about yet. Again, bullying is that little thing that, it's not a little thing, don't take it like that. Bullying pushes them over the edge. They're already teetering on that anyways. And then they've got people calling them names and pushing them down and stealing their shit and beating them up for just for being different. Once I got out of my bullying stage, I realized that the popular kids weren't the ones to hang out with. They're still not, unless you're one of them. I found out that the outcasts, the nerds, the dorks, they were the better friends because they were more loyal. You didn't have to worry about them talking shit behind your back. I mean, yes, there's exceptions to every rules. There are a few dickhead dorks because they fall for that. Oh, the popular kid's talking to me and I can be one of them. No, no, you're not. But I found they were more loyal friends and you could be yourself. You didn't have to act a certain way, which I've never been into acting different. I'm me. I dress the way I want to because I want to. I talk the way I want to. I cut my hair because the way I want to. I wear earrings because I want to. Everything I do is because how I feel about it. My wife will tell you, she doesn't like my favorite cologne. I very, very rarely wear cologne these days. And when she told me way back when we first started dating, she hated my cologne. I don't wear cologne for you. Now, when she gives me some that I think smells good and I'll wear it from time to time, but I very rarely wear cologne, but I don't wear cologne for other people. I wear it for me. I don't wear deodorant for other people. I wear it for me. I don't take showers or brush my teeth or shave for other people. All of that is for me, how I feel about myself. When I got fat, I mean, not that I'm skinny now, but compared to what I was 3 years ago, I'm in a lot better shape. I didn't lose weight because I was afraid of what people thought about me. I couldn't give a fuck less. It's how I felt about myself. And that's what we need to be teaching these kids. Is it's important how you feel about yourself. And if you don't like something about yourself, change it. But the whole thing about bullying is it's just escalated into something that fuck, man. It's even hard to put it into words. You see this shit all the time, and it's fucking, it's heartbreaking. It pisses me the fuck off. I cannot stand to see somebody bullying someone. And yes, there's different levels, and yes, all that stuff. But when I see kids being bullied, and they're not even fighting back, they didn't do anything to ask for that. They were just existing. But some cocksucker who has no idea who he is. He's a weak piece of shit too. However, he's physically stronger or more popular. Chooses to kick his ass or pick on him to belittle him. That's fucking ridiculous. So, it's easier to teach your kids to stand up for themselves. Yes, it could involve getting hurt worse, but you know what? Life's rough. Again, not justifying bullying. It's fucked up. But when you got kids out there that are killing themselves as children, junior high, high school, they don't know what life's about yet. Life hasn't really kicked their ass yet. That's something else that's beyond bullying. Bullying is the catalyst that pushes them over. It's fucked up, and there needs to be changes, and those people need to be held accountable. It's not like when I was a kid, we weren't killing each other. We weren't, you know, yes, you get stuff stolen, broken, all that kind of shit, and it made life bad. Bullying sucks, period. No, it doesn't matter if it was in the 70s or now. But the difference is, they weren't really fucking people up like they are today. So it's escalated into something that really needs to be addressed. And, I mean, stiffer penalties. And not like when I was a kid and they're like, oh, it's just boys being boys and you don't do that no more and blah, blah, blah. People are getting hurt, seriously hurt. And I know I don't need to tell you that part. But, you know, so when I hear people say, well, we got bullied in the 70s and the 80s, yes, but it was not like it is today. It's gotten worse. And it's fucking crazy. No one I went to school with while we were in school, I don't know if anybody's done it since, but no one I went to school with committed suicide. That doesn't mean nobody died. It just means nobody set out to commit suicide. You hear about it all the fucking time now. So there needs to be addressed, and not just people going, oh, it's wrong. There literally needs to be, they need to be held accountable. You know, a guy named Darnell, I can't remember his last name, when I first moved to Germany, he was a bully, but that's because he hung out with someone who was a tough guy who actually turned out not to be a tough guy either. But Darnell tried to bully me the first day of school. And when I slammed his face into the table, bent his arm behind his back, and let him know if he ever touched me again, I'd break his motherfucking arm. That set a precedence. He never fucking touched me again. His friend he hung out with knew not to touch me. Sometimes standing up, I mean, it's always the right thing to do. That doesn't always mean you're going to succeed. It's like I taught my kids. You always try to do your best at something, and that doesn't mean you're always going to win. Not everybody's a winner, and it's not always fair. I mean, when my daughter played volleyball, she kicked ass. But there was a girl on the team who, her parents were friends with the coach. They had a very strict rule about eating candy on the way to game. She got caught eating candy. She wasn't supposed to play in the game, but because her mama was friends with her parents, or because her coach was friends with her parents, she still got to play. Really? So you deal with shit like that. It happens. And when my daughter finished out that year of volleyball and said, fuck this, it just gets more political. You know, I don't want to do it anymore. But she finished out, and she learned a lesson. It's not always fair. And you can teach your kids. You should use setbacks to motivate you. I mean, when I played football in junior high and high school, if you're standing on the sideline without your helmet on, you ain't fucking going in. I see kids do it all the time now. Most of them probably out there because their parents are making them, not because they want to be out there. And that's a form of bullying too. If your kid don't want to play football, don't fucking make him. If your kid don't want to play any sport, don't fucking make him or her. That's just a guy thing. I say that. Son of a bitch, I'm almost up on 15 minutes. Don't bully your kids. Teach them to have self-worth, self-value, and stay true to themselves. You'll get through all this shit, and you'll move on, and you'll enjoy life. That's the number one thing I've told my kids. Be happy. That's it. Fuck, I know I kind of rambled, and some of you are going to go, well, does that really have to do with bullying? it's really kind of hard for me to convey what I need to say, because if I say something and you misinterpret in the video, it could get way out of proportion. But if we were having a one-on-one conversation and you went, what the fuck? I could correct it right then and it would be squashed right then. Not, well, son of a bitch, did you hear what he said? And let it stew and brew. So don't tell your kids, well, I was bullied when I was your age. It's a whole different thing. There are fucking kids out there hurting kids, physically fucking them up. They do need to learn to stand up for themselves. Yes, they can get hurt. I taught my daughter when she started school because I was so afraid of something happening about fighting. I taught her, it's not cool. It's not like it looks like in the movies. It sucks. I taught her what to do. If you go down, what to do. You know, don't bow down. You go down swinging. But once you get down, here's what you need to do. You need to be prepared. I didn't raise victims. I raised good, self-strong kids that are now adults that are succeeding. It sucks. I'm sorry if your kid's being abused or bullied, but you need to work with them at home, and we need to get shit passed to hold these fuckers accountable. Much stricter than what they are. Yeah. If I ever find, because I've actually looked for, two of them wouldn't accept friend invites, and they're in another state, so Facebook's the best I could do. They didn't accept my friend invites, which I understand. I mean, granted, that was when we were kids and now we're grown-ups, to apologize, and some of them I haven't been able to find, but I didn't bully that many people, but I feel bad about it. I don't carry it like, oh my God, but I would like to let them know, man, I'm sorry I fucking made your life miserable for a little bit. So, yeah, fuck it, I'm just rambling now. Stiffer penalties for bullies, and teach your kids, fuck them. You stay true to you, you keep your eye on your prize and your journey. Don't let anybody fucking knock you off that path. It still goes on, even as adults, you know? It is what it is. So, this one probably sucks worse than the first three, but I'm still trying to get back in the swing of things. Nobody's listening, but subscribe. I need subscribers. Like, hate, whatever you want to do. Give me some reaction. Until next time, peace.